Okay, students, let's have some brief introduction among ourselves. Welcome to IIMSE, Empowering People, Enhancing Education. Myself, a senior faculty in microbiology, will be taking classes for you people. May I know the students or attendees who are viewing this presentation? Hello?
Yeah, ma'am. We are able to see your screen, ma'am.
Okay, now. May have the introduction of the attendees who are viewing this presentation.
Yeah, guys, please tell your name and you are from which college? Anudeep. Yeah.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Anudeep. I'm from ISM IUK, Kyrgyzstan.
Okay.
Martin, please introduce yourself.
You are from?
Good afternoon, yeah. Ma'am. I am Martin from ISM IUK, Kyrgyzstan.
Okay. So, a very good afternoon. We will be dealing with the microbiology topics. And today's topic is on antibiotic resistance in bacteria. Throughout the history, there has been a continual battle between human beings and multitude of microorganisms that cause infection and disease. Emergence of antibiotic resistance is a major factor leading long-term successful use of an antimicrobial agent. With this brief background, we'll start our topic, and I'll be dealing the topics under these following heads, which includes introduction, definitions, the various factors that influence the resistance pattern, and the mechanism of action of resistance, and the mechanism of resistance, and how many types of resistance are there, and what are the various commonest organisms that develop this resistance, and how to detect these resistance patterns, and the short notes regarding mutational and transferable drug resistance, and the most common frequently asked questions in your undergraduate examinations, and the multiple choice questions which may be get in your NEET post-graduation entrance examination. Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Great. In this presentation, if you have any doubt while I'm going through it, you can ask me at any point and we'll clarify the doubt and we'll pass on to the next slide. Is it okay?
Okay, ma'am. Sure.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Before going to the slides, we must be well acquainted with the terms which we will come across in the presentation. The commonest terms are antibiotic resistant, resistant organisms, and superbug or superbacteria. To define antibiotic resistance, it is a drug resistance where a microorganism is able to survive exposure to an antibiotic with normal dosage. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, resistant organism is one that will not be inhibited or killed by an antibacterial agent at any concentrations of the drug achievable in the body after normal dosage. So, resistant organisms will develop such type of resistance called as when they were exposed to antibiotics is called as antibiotic resistant. So, superbugs are the bacteria that carries several resistant genes in it. So, they are called as superbacteria or multi-resistant bacteria or superbug. So, the various factors that contribute for antibiotic resistance are misuse of antibiotics. This is the most common factor which we will come across in our India. This is because of the use of antibiotics with no clinical indication. For example, in case of viral infections, most of the clinicians will be prescribing antibacterials to prevent secondary bacterial infection. But this will not have any effect on the viral infections. Likewise, use of broad-spectrum antibiotics were also not indicated, and appropriate administration of the antibiotic to a particular organism is indicated. And inappropriate choice of empirical antibiotics is also one of the contributing factors for resistance development. Another cause is overuse of antibiotics. Because of adherence, there won't be any activity against the bacteria because of this antibiotics. So overuse of antibiotics is one of the contributing factors. And in addition to these two factors, the other important and third upcoming or the emerging reason is addition of antibiotic to the feed of the livestock. So in developing countries like India, this is considered as the most important emerging factor. So this picture depicts the various antibiotics and various levels of the bacterial cell at which they act.
That's mine.
So, students, any problem? Hello?
No, ma'am, no, sorry.
So this picture, you must have a clear look about this picture because this picture depicts the various antibiotics that act at various levels of the bacterial cell. For example, if you take beta lactams and glycopeptides, they act on cell wall synthesis. So when a bacterium is comes across with these antibiotics, they act on the cell wall and thereby killing the bacterium. Likewise, sulfonamides, the para-aminobenzoic acid will be converted into dihydrofolic acid in the bacterial cell. So sulfonamides act at this level and thereby inhibiting the folic acid synthesis. Likewise, during the conversion of dihydrofolic acid to trihydrofolic acid, the drug trimethoprim will act, thereby inhibiting the synthesis of trihydrofolic acid. These folic acids are very essential for the development of DNA in the bacteria. So they cannot replicate once these antibiotics are implicated, so thereby killing the bacteria. Likewise, tetracyclines act by inhibiting the protein synthesis. However, they act on the 30S part of the ribosome, while microlides and lincomycins act on the 50S part of the ribosome. Another important anti-tuberculosis drug is rifampicin. This is DNA-directed polymerase. This acts on this particular enzyme and thereby inhibiting the synthesis of mRNA, inhibiting the growth of the bacteria. Likewise, the another important group and the most commonly used antibiotics belong to quinolone group. And these act on DNA gyrase enzyme, which inhibits the replication of the genetic material in bacteria. So once you have a clear-cut idea of the various antibiotics that act at various places, you can as well administer the drugs in your clinical practice. Till now we have discussed the antibiotics and its mode of actions. Now we will discuss about the mechanism pattern developed by the bacteria to combat these antibiotics. So broadly, antibiotic resistance in bacteria is classified into two types. One is the intrinsic type, the other one is the acquired. In acquired, it is again of two types. One is the genetic mechanism, the other one is the biochemical mechanism. So, genetic mechanism includes mutations as well as acquisition of new DNA particle to the other bacteria. Mutation is a sudden change in the structure of gene that leads to the mutational change in the gene. This is a sudden change in the genetic material. It may occur either in a single chromosome. For example, in case of streptomycin, mutations occurs in a single ribosomal protein. And also in case of sulfonamides, if there is a change in the amino acid level due to the change in the enzyme dihydropterase synthetase, there will be decreased affinity of the sulfonamides. And in this case of series of mutations, this is commonly seen in pneumococci, where the changes in the protein binding protein, which is present in the cell wall, causes the resistance to penicillin group of drugs. So coming to the next type, that is acquisition of new DNA by the bacterium to develop resistance. This may occur in three patterns. It may be either due to transformation, conjugation, or transduction. And during this process, the elements that are involved in transferring of DNA, they may be either plasmids or transposons. Plasmids are extra chromosomal genetic materials that can replicate independently and freely in the cytoplasm. And this is the most common pattern or the element that helps in the development of drug resistance in clinical practice is through plasmids. And transposons are the sequences of DNA that can move around different positions within the genome of the single cell. So you must have a clear-cut idea or differentiation between plasmid and transposon. Plasmid is an extra chromosomal DNA particle, and transposons are the sequences of DNA that can move within the genetic material, that is within a genomic, single genomic cell. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So you must be able to differentiate between plasmid and transposon. Which is plasmid is a extra chromosomal DNA particle, whereas transposon is a sequential change within the gene. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So this picture shows the three mechanisms by which the bacteria can be adapt to have that resistant gene. So the first and foremost part is transformation. Transformation is described or mentioned that if a dead bacterium is identified in the environment, if it consists the resistant gene, the simple transformation of this resistant gene into another bacterium, and this bacterium will incorporate the resistant gene and this will replicate in it. So this simple transformation of the resistant gene into a next bacterium is called as transformation. So the bacterium which receives the resistant gene is called as the acceptor, and the bacterium which donates the resistant gene is called as donor. And the another part is transduction. In this, the transformation of the transfer of resistant gene requires a vehicle for its transformation from one bacterial cell to the other bacterial cell. This is the vehicle in this process. This is nothing but the bacteriophage. This transfers the genetic material, that is the resistant gene, from one bacterium to the other bacterium. And the same procedure will continue in that. So the next part is the conjugation. In this is the remote method of transfer of resistant gene from one bacterium to another bacterium. The simple adherence of one bacterium to other bacterium will transfer the resistant gene from the donor to the recipient. So these are all plasmid mediated, especially in conjugation. These three modes help the transfer of genetic material from one bacterium to other bacterium, that is a resistant gene. And because of mutations, the target may also be changed. Usually, the target will, the antibiotic will adhere to the target and thereby killing the bacteria occurs. If at all any mutation occurs, the target will be altered. Thereby, the antibiotic cannot adhere to the or attach to the target protein. So thereby, the bacteria will develop resistance in this pattern also. So another important thing is the antibiotic usually enters the bacterial cell through pouring channels. These are the pouring channels, and once the antibiotic is administered, it will attach or it will pass through the pouring channel to the interior of the bacterial cell. However, if there is any alteration in the pouring material, likewise, here this picture shows this is the normal pouring channel and this is the altered pouring channel, that is a new pouring channel which does not allow the antibiotic to enter to the interior of the bacterial cell. So in this procedure also, the antibiotic cannot kill the bacteria. So these are all due to the changes in the mutations that will occur in the bacteria. And another this thing is, antibiotics normally bind to specific binding proteins on the bacterial cell wall. These are the binding proteins where the antibiotic goes and attaches to the binding part, and it will help in the transfer of antibiotic into the interior of the organism. Due to the mutations, the block, the binding protein will change its procedure, and thereby the antibiotic cannot attach or cannot binding protein, and this will inhibit the transfer of antibiotic to the interior of the bacterial cell. Thereby, this antibiotic cannot penetrate into the interior of the bacterial cell and it doesn't act on it. Thereby, it develops resistance or the antibiotic is inefficient for its action. So, to remember easily, the organisms that are that develop resistance commonly are broadly classified into gram-positive and gram-negative organisms. Gram-positive includes Staphylococcus aureus and Enterococcus species, and gram-negative, the most common organism is Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Escherichia coli, Klebsiella species, Acinetobacter and Salmonella. So we have discussed the various mechanisms and various mutational changes that will develop in the bacteria to develop resistance. Now, how to identify the antibacterial resistance in a routine laboratory? So this includes two types of methods, that is disk diffusion method. The other one is tube broth dilution method. With the help of these two methods, you can identify the antibiotic resistance pattern in the routine laboratories. So the important short notes in this chapter you will be getting is the differences between mutational and transferable drug resistance. In case of mutational, it is usually because of single drug and it has low degree of resistance, and if the dosage of the antibiotic is increased, then it will act, so there will be some beneficial effect because of mutational changes. However, it can be prevented by use of combination of drugs, and it will develop low virulence of the bacteria. This is almost in opposite to the transferable drug resistance, which is because of it may be either due to conjugation, transformation or transduction. And it usually develops in multiple drugs, and degree of resistance is high when compared to mutational changes. And even after the dosage of the drug is increased, it is not benefited, and cannot be prevented by combination of drugs, and the bacteria usually shows high virulence. The commonly asked questions in this topic are, describe the resistance pattern in the bacteria, and what are the various genetic mechanisms of drug resistance in bacteria, and the short notes is differences between mutational and transferable drug resistance. This completes the topic. And if you have any queries in this topic, you can as well ask me and we'll clear it now itself. Can I have any questions from the audience?
No, ma'am.
Okay, then it's time for me to ask you questions regarding this topic. Is it fine with you people? Hello? Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I ask you some of the questions which were discussed in the presentation? I'm fine even if you won't answer it. Let me answer the questions.
Okay, ma'am.
So acquisition of naked DNA by bacterium from environment and incorporation into its genome is?
All of the above.
No. From Martin? Martin, can you answer this?
Transformation.
Transduction.
That is transformation.
Okay. Yeah.
You want me to show the diagram again?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Naked DNA transformation.
Let me show the picture. So, this is a bacterium which is formed dead in the environment, and simple transfer of genetic material, that is resistant gene, from the donor to the recipient is transformation. Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we move on to the next question? Hello?
Yes, ma'am, sure.
So, for this question, I can expect an answer from Raghunath, is it? So first, let me read out the question. Penicillin resistance in Staphylococcus is due to? This we have discussed in the presentation itself. Am I audible? Shall we discuss the slide once again?
Yeah, Raghu, please answer.
No.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what is the answer for the second question?
Here we have...
Let me explain you one second.
Yeah, some problem with Raghu audio system, ma'am. Just unmuted Raghu. Yeah, Raghu, please answer.
So shall I tell you the answer?
Yes, ma'am. Conjugation, ma'am.
No, it's transduction. So now we'll see third question. Drug resistance in tubercle bacilli is due to? Tuberculosis is one of the most common diseases in India, isn't it? Isn't it? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Plasmid mediated.
No, it is mutation. Mutation is considered as a sudden change in the genomic sequence, isn't it? So, tubercle bacilli has suddenly developed resistance to rifampicin. So it is considered as mutational change. Is it fine?
Yes, ma'am.
So fourth question, we'll move on to fourth question. Segment of DNA that can move within the genome is?
Transposon.
Exactly. Good. Genetic variations are usually, are they stable or unstable?
Stable, ma'am.
Yeah, good. Thanks for your patience listening and patient answering. Have a nice day.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, we'll go.